Hello everyone, and welcome back to another Robot Showcase video. Yeah, it's not been too long since the last one, but I've got a few robots to show you now. I've got 8 to show you today. So yeah, let's stop talking and start going really, because I've got a lot today. First, we have quite a notable robot, a recent fan-made robot wars. One that's about time I built this. Wildcard, yes. In overall design, it's not too difficult to make it more of a colouring job. I think it did quite well. We've got wild card, and the stripes, all sorts of magic stuff, and the face, that's got the cards on as well. If you look under here, you can see back of the card, the OP bottle, and the system. Look under here, you can see the absolute mess I made of that, and also the thing in there, which I couldn't tell what it said on it, so I just hide the text, hydraulics, you know. The flippers are quite good, but I think I might need to redo the front card, because, well, that, also it's not really that long, you can't. I've got panic attack here. You see, you have to get quite close up. And also the one in Omega does look like a long front card. Yeah, top flipper. It goes stronger than that usually, but I just don't really want to go faster. Got crossfire here. Yeah. More of that sort of thing. Yeah, that is Tiger. Next up is what you've seen these before. These the New Wave Heat Wave robots, but I thought I'd show you them up close because it's gonna get quite good. In the episode, first we have everyone's favourite, the MRB. If you know, you know, very nice. Got the wallpaper design on the top, the fridge at the front, and of course, what's in the fridge? Thick cooking oil, and down the side, we've got things like a plum, a windmill, pizza, like goldfish, chocolate cake, and that's going to be a television. But yeah, it's a fairly decent brand new slipper. You saw. Did in the, oh dear, it's one of my, saw how it did in the episode. Yeah, this one could do fairly well going forward. Next up, of course, we have Technotron. Didn't quite do as well as I thought it would. It's got the flipper up front with the thing in there, so you can draw the CO2 bottle, and also the drum on the back, which is quite easy to get tense, I might think. Also, it's got the red lips, which aren't very good. I might fix those in place. I need to add some kind of size self-right, of course. I'm showing you these in order I built them, as usual. Next up, we have quite a good robot, Prius, which it's a relatively simple design. If you look close, you can see I've done that flipper there. Just one long reinforced panel. Then the top extra armor layer on top, sort of designed like Beast, the Series 8 live event version of Beast, that is, with these sort of curved flippers, the exposed armor struts. But yeah, it was quite good, fairly low to the ground. Yeah, Prius. Now, next up is not Lumberjack, because before I built that, I built another robot, which I'm not overly happy with. This was just sort of rushed thing I did. I felt like building a robot, didn't know what to do. I went on the BattleBots wiki and just scrolled through pages till I found something that looked easy to build. And so I built Slapbox. Yeah, not massively happy with this one. You can see the terrible hands I drew on the top. I'm not good at drawing any part of the human anatomy, especially hands. And there's some outside. The wheels, I did alright. Back isn't terrible, but the wedge that's in front, there's the underneath, and the lifter does work. We get, who have we got? That's crikey. It does work nice, and it can go down, so you can do that as well. Can't self right, well, I suppose it could, but it never really did in the show. Yeah. Slapbox, not brilliant, but not terrible. And speaking of terrible, the last robot from New Wave Heat Wave, and problem of the week is the lumberjack, which is something I threw together at last minute. I needed a fourth robot and didn't know what to do. Jeff's got the axe, which is quite twisted after their encounter with Technotron. Yeah, it comes down fairly well. Wheel guards are a bit broken. You see the mess of hot blood in the wheels and stay on and in the track mechanism. Yeah, it's not the worst thing ever, but it's definitely not the best. But yeah, that's the lumberjack. Could be better, but I don't know, maybe I'll upgrade it. I'm thinking of adding some big front wedge at the front. So yeah, we'll see where that one goes. Second to last robot now, we have another one I'm not overly happy with. It was like Slapbox really. I wanted to build a robot on Lunarverse. But there's a custom one. This here is Rage Bolt, which is a stupid name for a stupid robot. Very, very bright colours on this. It's got the bolt going through the middle, which does match up on the sides. You can see the front panels don't match up with the top, which is mildly annoying. And you can see its weapon, which is a dual spiked axe here, which swings with an alright amount of force. Don't hit it too hard, it isn't that great. And you can see the in the side. It's sort of a terror thing. It was originally going to be a flipper, but I decided to do an axe because I've got loads of flippers. Will it do well? Probably not. Will I ever use it? Maybe. If I need some filler in a heap, I might put it in, but yeah, not the best robot, but it's alright. The last robot is one I'm fairly happy with. Again, this is a BattleBox robot. One that failed to qualify. They were rejected for the 2021 season, even though it aired in 2022. This is the Australian robot, MacGuffin. Designed by Team Panic, of course. See the front wedges, they were a real pain to get the angles on. But I got there in the end, see the top panel with all the bolts in it. And the slots where the wheels would be, they continue down on the underside. It's also got spinners. The spinners were gold on the actual one, but I didn't have any gold colouring implements, so I just had to do this. But yeah, it does work like the real one if we get Death Drop or not. I really need to recolour Death Drop. I left it in the sun and it's gone a bit yellow. But yeah, if it was a spinner, say a Russian tank to hit and then just spin around and kick it with those discs there. And of course, if it's lit, it still runs. Yeah. But yeah, that was pretty good. I'm fairly happy with that one. Right. If I were to rank my favourites from this allotment, who would we have? I'd say probably in third would be Wildcard. Second, I think I'd put in Technotron. And first, got to be up there. Of course, it's getting happy. Yeah, but that's sort of all I've got to say for this one. So yeah, join me next time when it's more of this, isn't it? That's what you subscribe for. Yeah, bye.